guys. Hi. Keto says hi. So this is what I'm going to try to make. It's salmon with lemon caper sauce. I need to be keto. And I hate fish. Oh, Kiki. You're so bossy. Yeah, you are. There you go. Okay, so, thank you. Alexa, play the next song. I don't know why it keeps playing that song. I don't have it on my list.
That was the last song. Starting
over. No, don't start over. Alexa, play my Spotify music. It's not playing Spotify. Alexa, play Spotify.
Here's Spotify. Here's bedtime stories.
No, Alexa, play. Here we go again. Alexa, play my favorite songs. Alexa, play my liked playlist. This isn't it. Alexa, play my liked playlist. She just cut me off. Alexa, play my liked playlist. Alexa, play the next song. Okay, I think we're good now. I had the same fight with her the other night. Hello, Idaho. Connection on my end is good, so if you're having issues, you might need a refresh on your end. Feed the cat. He's happy. He's eating now. Chat the things you wish you knew when you were younger. I knew everything when I was younger. All right, guys. Oh, you like my teeth? I like them too. Hello. You should say please when making looks. I used to. I always. Okay, you're right. You're right. Okay. So first off, I wanted to start off with an unboxing. I know in the past I've always been really bad at, like, making it clear who got it for me before, like, I knew if they were okay with me sharing that they got it for me. On my last cooking live, I sliced my finger, just a little tiny prick, with the knife. My knives are very dull. They're terrible. They're cheap knives. Like, they move at the hint. It's bad. So everybody was, like, telling me I need to get better, sharper knives. I'm like, well, if I had the money, I would. So somebody bought me a brand new set of knives. I'm not gonna say who, just in case they, like, you know, because people like to be anonymous or whatever, but if they want to take credit, they are allowed to. But I did thank them. But this is the unboxing now. In the past, I have not been very good at not saying who it was. I'm like, okay, I gotta wait for so-and-so to get in here. So I'm going to be good this way. So this has, it has the chef knife, bread knife, carving knife, utility knife, paring knife, santoku knife, steak knife, kitchen shears, sharpening, like a knife sharpening thing, and the block. And it tells you even how warm tips. The kitchen knife is very sharp. Well, that's good. Okay, so we're good. I read the instructions. We're fine. Oh, he probably is. Or sexist from a pert in the past, maybe. I don't know. Anyways, can't ruin my day. So, you guys want to see? So this is the block. it's so nice and chic and shiny. Guess what's in here? The name. That's so true. Unless they belong to me. Yeah. That's accurate. That's accurate. You know, like when you have like a box that's full of something sharp, like knives or scissors, and you need knives or scissors to open it. Just little ironies in life that I find amusing. Alexa, turn the music down one. Okay. Does the thing look like? What does that thing look like? A face? Oh. So, whenever I get cereal, if I see a cereal box that has a toy inside, I most likely get it, even if it's not like the cereal I was wanting. And the General Mills cereals had this like thing where they had like these variety of cereal character mascots in boxes, and you had to collect them all. I have more than this, but these are the two that I have out. It's the Cookie Crisp and Cinnamon Toast Crunch. It doesn't say the name. But yeah. I got two of these. Thank you, Andrew, for the rose. Thank you, thank you. Which is a little bit taller. I think the other ones are in here, maybe. I don't remember where I put them. I had these two on the fridge, but yeah, that's what that is. Well, I think it's the Cookie Crisp Wolf. Pretty sure. That's where I... Yeah, that's the... Yeah, that's the box I got it in. I am back to cooking. So, I am doing an unboxing of the new knife set that I received for my cooking, considering I, like, cut myself... last time. Ooh, and it even has a little, like, blade guard at the tip. But it's right here. Ooh. Ooh. Oh my gosh, this is nice. Yeah, I like this. I like this. How tall are you? I could smell. Ready to go. Me too. Me too. Oh my goodness. How sweet. My goodness. Well, in my thing, I give me. Oh my goodness. Okay, so this is one of the knives. I should see what. So I'm trying to make salmon with lemon caper sauce. And the thing about this is I've tried salmon in the past many times, and I just don't like it at all. And the smell, like, I'm really sensitive to smell and fish smell, and I don't like the texture, and it just feels gross eating fish for some reason. Even though I grew up, like, my dad, we would go fishing, like, he'd make fish stuff. but the reason I picked this, because it was like a free, like, 7-10 meal offer from Green Chef, and Green Chef offers like this is, for example, paleo, gluten-free, and Mediterranean, like, approved. the purpose for me is because what fish, especially salmon, and this is Atlantic salmon, so it's like the best that you can get, apparently. It has like nutrients I need that I don't really get anywhere else. So It's really not for taste, it's for health. Hopefully the taste is, I'm gonna give it a shot. I'm gonna give it a shot because like so far these meals have been really tasty. Of course they're food items I like. So we'll see how this goes. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I mean I'm not microwaving it, but or you mean like the vent? Okay, yeah, on the stove and stuff. Yeah. Yeah, I'm not looking forward to that. But that's good reminder. I will put the microwave vent on. But Chef is here to help. Oh, nice. All right, so this is the. That's not a very helpful picture, actually. Where's the box? Where did I see? Okay. I saw like much better photos showing which knives were what. Maybe it was online. I think I saw it online, maybe. Because these don't really, like these don't really help me of knowing which knife is what exactly. Okay, so this, please don't nuke this fish. Honestly, maybe it'll taste better for me. I don't know. So this is, oh, it says steak knife. Oh, it says it on there. You guys, it says what kind of knife it is on the knife. That is so helpful. So helpful. I needed that. Where, why didn't they do that to all the other knives I've ever had? Santoku knife. I'm so excited. Pictures of knives. Ooh, you hear that? Hold on. I'll do it again. Ooh. Perfect knife for Jessie. Like, with fish, the sauce is glazed could be the game changer. I hope so. It does have this sauce. I don't know what caper means. It says lemon caper sauce. I like lemon sauce, like with steaks and stuff. I don't know what the caper means, but we can fancy up in here. We are that new knife's on, right? So this is the Santoku knife. Anybody know what that means? Capers are peppery. Is it spicy? Because I don't like spice. Like, at least with fish, I'm willing to try it with spice. Like, anything, like, spicy, I mean, I can't even try it. It's just spicy. You know, you can't change that. What's a Santoku knife? Is it briny flower bed? Oh, okay. Hey, Oklahoma! Like, tangy. Okay, I can do tangy. I'm okay with tangy. Small like peas, lots of flavor. Okay. Why do you talk like that? Why do I talk like what? Like that? Why do you type like that? Well, I mean, I figured it's a Japanese knife because it's a Japanese type name, but what does it mean? What kind of knife? What's it for? Like, what do I use a knife for? I mean, I has the ridges, and somebody once told me it was to slice, like, fruits and stuff, but Chicago! This is also a steak knife. What the? Two steak knives? Yeah, I fed him, so I don't know why. He just wants attention now. So there's, same thing. Okay, same thing, two steak knives identical. Well, that's nice of them. It's funny of them to assume I'm gonna have company over for steak. Unless they're making it, then, you know. I'm gonna have the steak all to myself. Thank you, Ferengo. Chef knife, it can be used for chopping and slicing larger meats. Okay, well then, Mr. Chef Josh, riddle me this. If that's for cutting meat, then what is the chef knife for, or the carving knife for then? Just saying. I haven't even started yet. I'm still doing the unboxing of my new knife set. Riddle me this. It's great. Oh, it's another. Oh, I have like what? Like, do I have like four steak knives? That's wonderful. I'm excited. Curvy knife is for pumpkins. I knew that's what I thought. Honestly, I mean, like, not really, but like that's what came to my mind in my sarcastic mind. Ooh, it's a pottery knife. This is what I use to slice apples. And people that piss me off. I'm just kidding. Or am I? It should have been this American version. So I seriously just have two different knives that do the same thing. Like what Americans couldn't handle, like the Japanese having a knife to cut meat, so we had to make our own. Sounds about right, actually. Oh, here's the sharpening thing. New to this. Hey, girl, hey! Ooh, another steak knife. So do I have? I have a set of four steak knives, and maybe. Ooh, do I have two paring knives? Because I seriously do use the paring knife a lot for snacks. It's different. You say it's like the same thing, and then you say it's different. Like, same page here, you know. Now I just feel like you're just making things up. Aw, thank you, Kenny. Hey, girl, hey! I'm sure I'm doing a poor job at describing it. You are. I'm just kidding. I mean, you are, but. So we're doing a cooking live. And when I say that, I want to make it very clear, I am not a cook. I am not a chef. Oh, wires! I guess I have a knife. Yes, look what I got! I got a new set of knives. I'm only have a couple, a few left more to go. Unfortunately for you guys, that's only on Twitch. The more knives they make up, the more they can charge for the set. Now that's capitalism. Full disclaimer, Jessie is not a chef, but she means well. Exactly. So, where was the invite? I didn't send any invites out because by the time I got done, everybody was already in here, so I don't know where you went. And this is another steak knife. Wait, there's no more. Oh, that doesn't go there, I guess. That goes here. So I have like a full row of steak knives. I have six steak knives. How many people do they think I'm gonna share my steak with? Silly. I put that there. Ridiculous. And I'm already awesome. I love to cook. I used to work. Oh, really? Nice. Twitch streaming. I stream on Twitch as well. Usually, at least right now, Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays with consistency-ish. And a utility knife. Like, when I hear utility knife, I'm thinking like the kind that like I put in my back pocket when I go places. I'll do you one better. Why is Twitch? not cooking related, hand wash them and never put in the dishwasher. It does say it's dishwasher safe though. I need things that are like easy, you know? What are the differences between. Yes, Josh! Chef Josh needs Chef Baby's help. And I swear, if Chef Baby says they're like the same thing and then continues on to say that but they're different, I swear I'm done. I'm done. Oh, thank you, Leon. I appreciate that. Just me. That's funny. I'm trying to keep up with comments, guys. Nice to meet you. Thank you, Leon. Is going to Turkey for plastic surgery to make yourself. Okay. Hey. Things that are easy. Raise his hand. Always hand wash your knives. Again, I have to reiterate, it seems that the box says they are dishwasher safe. Okay, so utility knife. In cooking, what does that mean? Because I see utility knife, I think of like cutting rope out hiking, mountain climbing. I see it when I'm like needing to open cardboard boxes, get the metal too hot and can bend the blades. But it says it's and precise cuts. Well, okay, so riddle me this then. What's the difference between a paring knife? Paring or paring knife and a utility knife, then. I mean, besides the obvious size, oh, there's dust on there. besides the size, I mean, fine, wash them in the dishwasher, thank you. Because the part is smaller, so if it's for smaller size cuts, you would want to use this, I would think. Part knife is a smaller... Josh, I swear. Pretty much Josh, Chef Josh, is explaining all these knives are pretty much the same, they're just different. Lemons and limes. Yeah, I use the paring knife for my apples usually. It's for small objects and trimmings. Okay, Chef Baby, then counter that with utility knife. It's trimming and skinning also, and pears. One, I use one size knife for everything. That's what I'm saying. Oh wait, we still got a couple more. Alright, are you this for shimmy and shimmy also? Okay, so, okay, this is a bread knife. This, thank God, there's an easy-to-understand knife. It's a bread knife, and it looks different than all the other knives, and it says bread knife, and I understand what bread is. It's for large objects and for me. Okay. So paring knife is for smaller objects and trimming, and the utility knife is for larger objects and trimming. Then what is the difference between a utility knife and... Where did I put it? Okay, fine, you win. Turns into unboxing a knife tutorial. Welcome to cooking with me. This is how it goes. Chef's knife. Santoku knife. It's a prelude. Yes. That's strictly for frozen foods that will cut right through. Ooh, that sounds... What knife do you use for that? Do you use the chef's knife or the santoku knife or the utility knife? Which knife do you use for said thing? I do see the differences. Thank you. That one is obvious. The visual differences are obvious. I just need to understand why. Smartass. One last knife. I've never had a full set of knives. Like, and the knives that I have had were like a mixture of like hand-me-down knives. One is for striking, the other is for... I like you. This is so fun. Oh my gosh. And this is... You guys thought you were done. So we went through the paring knife is for small slicing, right? I just want to make sure you said small items like slicing to slice, right? And then we have the utility knife for slicing bigger things, right? And then we have the chef knife and the shiitake knife, right? They're all for slicing things, right? Different size things, right? What the hell is a slicing knife then? What? This is a slicing knife? What are these things then? They're imposters. Machete. I'm not gonna chop it. Garlic onions. Ooh, see, now that's helpful. Thank you, Leon. Where's your fillet knife? I don't know what the frick is a fillet knife. That's right. Good knife to chop wood. It has a smaller... God. It's for chopping like potatoes, which doesn't stick to the knife. Deboning things as well, that doesn't sound pleasant. Works well for that. A good knife is when you can put your finger on it. Total balance. Ooh, that sounds nice. That is true, though. Slicing knife. Thanks, not a knife. This is a knife. Oh my gosh. Slicing or cooked products like sliced your meats. I've never heard that knife called a slicing knife. That's more of a fish knife, but not thin enough. So you're telling me that this is the same thing as like this knife. I need like a list of items that like I use for each knife, you know? Maybe that's what I need to do. I just need like a category of like this knife I cut these things with and do these things with. This is hard. Hello, electric carving knife. That's amazing. The knife is longer and thinner to get clean. Okay, see, that's a little helpful. I mean, obviously, besides the clear, obvious visual differences, which I am very able to see, that's what I need to know to get clean cuts. So does the bigger one not get clean cuts then? I don't want a knife that doesn't give me clean cuts, so why do I have the bigger knife then? You guys are supposed to know this. Is a smaller chef knife. Person shank is a necessity. Okay. So now I got my knife set all nice and orderly. Isn't it sexy? Okay. I'm so freaking excited. I can actually cut things. Hopefully not my finger this time. Wash it and we'll produce clean cuts. Alright, so. Salmon with lemon caper sauce. You ready? It's a very nice looking knife set. Yeah, thank you. Let's see the menus. Right? Hello, Nick! Hello! How are you? I thought I was following you. Do the paper test. Isn't that bad for the knives though? Like, as a chef, like, wouldn't she, like, and the shoes you have in there that look like scissors, therefore when you cut like, yes. I use the scissors a lot, like with cutting pizza. I'm doing good. I just unboxed my new knife set that somebody sent to me. It's the first full, actual, legit knife set I've ever had in my life. So that's exciting, and I'm gonna try to make this. I don't even like salmon, so we're gonna see if it can win me over with a green chef meal prep thing. Not paper. I didn't buy them. It was somebody on my cooking live last time. I cut my finger, small little tiny cut, you know, and everybody saw Chef Baby was there, at least for this point, and was like, your knives aren't sharp enough. I'm like, well, and like the blades are like moving from the handle. They're terrible knives. I've had them for years. They were hand-me-downs. So somebody's like, you know, put a knife set on your wish list and I'll buy them for you. And I'm like, what? I'm like, well, I don't even know what kind of knives are good, you know? And so they sent me a link of the ones that they suggested and I added it to the wish list and now I got it. So yeah, and some panties and bubble. Oh my gosh. Sending you books and a bubble and some band-aids. I do have some Pokemon band-aids. So it has to be super fresh or it's a no-go for me. Me too. I honestly don't know how this is gonna go. Cause I just don't like, I've tried many times like fancy restaurants and even. The only time I've been able to eat fish has been somebody made I think it was catfish. Made catfish and I swear it tasted like steak. Like, it was amazing. Like, steak obviously tastes better technically, but like, it was so close. There was no fishy smell, no fishy taste. It was very disarming. And I was like, okay. But I've been told that salmon is not the same thing at all, like catfish, in order to do that sort of thing. Obviously, it's not the same thing, but you know what I mean. Maybe. It's still worth bandits. Totoro! Sushi or at Eddie V's. So, this is Atlantic salmon skin on portions, which I think sounds disgusting already. Sustainably farm raised. So this is supposed to be like, it's Green Chef. They pride themselves on like really healthy meals and whatnot and ingredients. It even has a QR code. It says Atlantic salmon salar, color added through feed. They do that? That's weird. So if I had like certain food that changed my skin color, I could be any color I wanted to be? That's cool. Although great care is taken to remove them, bones may be present. Shit! I'm gonna die! If it smells, it's not fresh. Okay. Try mahi-mahi, it's meaty, not very fishy. Why I used to fish if you take the catfish and put it in spring water and... What? What? Why? Definitely more fishy in nature, but with lemon and capers, it should be... Okay. Not be as bold. Okay, that's what I'm looking for. I did say a bad language word. I just read the label. Too much easier. Beta carotene. Don't try tilapia. Eat too many carrots and you'll turn orange. I tried that when I was younger once. It didn't work. Maybe I didn't eat enough. I was trying, you know. Thought that was cool. All right, now we have time to see what ingredients we have. Yay! Tartar for the first course. That sounds disgusting. We have sliced almonds. So far, great ingredient. I like almonds. Sliced almonds are even better. Hello, hello. Ooh, and we have broccoli. I like broccoli. We have organic broccoli. Ooh. And oh, we have more artichoke hearts. Always good for those. Always like those. Sun-dried tomato. It does not look like a tomato. I thought they were like dates or something. They're sun-dried tomatoes. Okay. I mean, they're fine. I like tomatoes. Where am I? More like. Have you got. Oh, okay. After the color of your skin turns if you eat too much of it. Stick around for this. What's going on? I need to go to. Oh my gosh. You'll want to stick around. Especially for this one because I've never cooked fish before because I don't like fish. So it's going to be interesting. This is, I was doing HelloFresh, but I ran out of free meals, so then I switched. This is Green Chef. And Green Chef is really big on like pure healthy ingredients. They have like paleo, gluten free, Mediterranean, all that stuff. This meal in particular is paleo, gluten free, and Mediterranean approved, I guess. Oh, thank you. I told you I'm down to cooking videos. Don't think I was kidding. You're roasting chicken and spinach and walnut sweet potato stuff and Yep, exactly. I deal with multiple autoimmune diseases. My sister has celiac. I have the Crohn's. So these kind of things are actually really good for me as well. And that's why I'm another reason why I'm doing it. But I also deal with other stuff that causes health like. It would be beneficial for me health-wise all around. I don't have a fish spatula. What is that? Is that a thing? There's something really big. What the hell? Is that a squash? I have a squash. I've never cooked with squash before. Dual cooking show for people with autoimmune conditions. Right? Right? I cook lactose intolerant and cook gluten free. Ooh, nice. I do try to do gluten free and lactose free stuff. I'm not lactose intolerant, but you know, it doesn't hurt to have that butternut squash. Nice. Yeah. I thought it was bread. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Okay. Got one more. Ooh, this is it. This is the lemon caper sauce with basil. So I love basil and I like lemon. I guess we'll see if I like the caper. All right. So that's that. And guacamole. I do like guacamole. Basil. I have several different kinds of basil growing in my little like aero garden over there. I don't know what the difference is. I didn't know there's different kinds, but there they are. They didn't send. Yeah, they didn't. I don't know what they are, but yeah, I'm okay that they did it for me. Basil of Baker Street. Okay, so the secret to tonight's flavor-packed seafood dish are luscious lemon caper sauce with basil, which brings bright and tangy flavors to pan-seared salmon fillets. The fish is served over a colorful base of garlicky sautéed broccoli, artichokes, and sun-dried tomatoes. Roasted butternut squash with toasted almonds makes for an earthy, sweet side. I love how like dramatic they are. Our unopened flower buds, which get pickled. Oh, okay. Okay. Oh, da-da-ba-ba, da-da-ba-ba. Okay. So as always, the first step is always to preheat the oven, which I do not do because it always takes me a really long time to get to the point where I actually need to put it in the oven. So, take your anxiety meds. Y'all have 911 on standby. It sounds good. I team. Woo! All right. So, remove any seeds from butternut squash with a spoon. Okay, there are some seeds. Knife or something. Not as easy as getting seed out of pumpkins, I'll tell you that much. Sheesh. Okay, a seed-free squash. Knife pairing. Pairing. Okay. Maybe I just like to say it fancy. Potting knife. Excuse me while I get to my potting knife. Okay. First step done. Don't even get into the single coupling knife, and I don't even start. Carefully peel with a. I'm not done with this stupid squash. Carefully peel with a sharp peeler. Medium. Okay. Now I gotta go peel it. That was my cat. Did you just say meow? What do I look like? A cat jumping from limb to limb all nimbly bimbly? You're fired. All right, hold on. Can I bring the trash can over here? Okay. Oh my God. Uh-oh. This is ouch. They're not going in the trash can. Oh shit. Okay, this is getting everywhere. Okay, oh. Why is it not going in the trash can? Okay, we're gonna demonstrate. Okay. Maybe I like need to get like an angle. Ah! There we go. You just need to go like from all the way. Shit! It's like a new game! That I suck at! Maybe if I angle it like. Seriously! It's going over. Why did you not go in the trash can? Okay, maybe if I go like in. There we go. Can I hire somebody to peel? Oh, there we go. The couple went in there. Get off! Get off! Okay. So a few more. I don't even know why I'm trying. Maybe Okay, I'm just gonna step over that mess. Cooking with me. You need to pill around, be a little later on, and I don't know what this means. I'm both laughing and crying. There's literally, like, could you guys see from there what was happening? Oh my gosh. Like, I don't understand. No matter which angle, it had a mind of its own. I would do it in the sink, but the sink has things in it. I am, but not when it comes to food. It's still raining squash. There's more to where that came from. Stay tuned. Oh god. Alright. There's something else I have to peel, hopefully. Stick to your cereal recipes. No, we're still in step one. Silly. Alright, so now that it's peeled, we can carefully or medium dice into pieces about half inch each. That's a lot. Thank you, on the edge of my seat and hungry. We're only cooking. We're not even seeing me all. Thank you, Brian. No, nice, no. Santoku knife, thank you. My handy dandy brand new Santoku knife. That somebody on here was graciously gifted me. So I'm trying to make. No, trust me. I'm not preheating the oven quite yet. This is gonna take me a long time. Trust me on this one. Let's see. I personally want it would just stop being into four pieces and start sauteing in oil. Emotional damage! In an hour when she's on step three. Yes! Cyberwolf, hi! You make us laugh and have more. Thank you, Leon. Mesh glove! Ooh! I definitely need that. You're so right, Lyndon. You're going to do fine. You're doing fine. She was fine. I'm doing fine. I am doing fine. Okay. You know what? I'll preheat the oven. We'll see how this goes. We'll see how this goes. All right, preheat oven to 400 degrees. We'll see how this goes. Put that right there. Let's see if I can beat it. Okay, half and half and half. So, yeah, I'm just gonna. I don't know what I'm doing. So, and I go like that, right? I go like, oh, it's keto. Is there like a, you like slice, like you'd slice like that down? Is there a way that you're supposed to slice? Like force-wise, like angle-wise, anything? I know that you're going to do your hands coming in. She made a bone. Cut in half, more manageable. Okay, I'll do that then. They give you the server in restaurants. I do have garlic. Against the grain. But I have to cut it in I have to cut it in pieces, like. Here, then. Oh my gosh. What you need is a nice, it looks like a rocker that has a rocker. What? Oh, Jesus. Away from your finger. No. Okay, so. Yeah, like the big thing, I don't have one of those. His chef is looking away. He's already freaked out. You're east. I'm in the middle coast. Stay baby for the loving Jesus. Okay. So I'll cut it in lengthwise because the grain is lengthwise. Because maybe that's just how I peeled it. There is no grain on a squash. Do you see any grain on here? Where the hell is the grain? That doesn't make any freaking sense. There's no grain. It's squash. Forward. Let the blade do the work. Don't apply too much. Okay, that's. Finally, somebody has something helpful to say. In the middle of the coast. Thank you for the prayers. There's no grain. All right, I'm gonna slice it in half this way. Oh yeah. Slice. Let it do the work. Okay, and I'm gonna just keep doing that, I guess. You guys see? Okay, good. Okay, I'm just gonna like get the feel for it, I guess. Maybe you'll see how it goes. Oh, did you guys see that? That was so smooth. Hold on, let me try again. Okay, that was got a, I got I lost momentum there. I lost the momentum there. Guys, do you see this? There, look at the camera. Right? You have to do the hand to hold it. Oh, curl the fingers of your other hand to hold the squash. Not a grain. Point your fingers with your non-bloody hand. Okay. I mean, I only looked at the phone when I stopped. I wasn't actively slicing and looking, I promise. I don't think I was. I didn't feel like I was. Okay, hold on. Okay, so like this, how am I supposed to. Watch to make sure. Okay, it's getting a little harder because this edge is like scooped. It's a scoop. I'm gonna cut this way. It's a little harder. Maybe this way. There we go. Ooh, so nice. It's like really hard right there, I guess. Oh, you see, that was scary. Start over. Toward the blade, curl under so your nails are flat against the squash. Like I'm clawing into the. Later, Jess, going. Bye! Have fun. Hold your knife with your fingers on the blade too, and the right knife. I retried the book. I am a weapons master. But not with cooking. This is not a weapon, it's a cooking utensil. It's very different things. Okay. Ooh, that was a nice slice. I don't care what any of you say, that was nice. So like this, but like this. Okay, like this? I think this is doing it right. Like that. Oh, that was way too thin. Got stuck. Is that like it? Yay! Did it. Don't have an eyebrow, I can't wait. achievement unlocked. Yay! So your knuckles act as a guide and stuff. I don't want to chop my knuckles off. Never oops in the kitchen, right? Okay, so now I need to cut these. And what'd I tell you? What'd I tell you? I haven't even finished cutting. What'd I tell you? Okay, so the picture is like, they just look like little squares. Tight pieces. So do I chop, like, does this knife, is this for this? Like, I chop down. I need a chopping knife. Can I chop like this? Is this acceptable? Split and Josh. You ready to take a double close? Oh my god, stop. I know, somebody told me that I need to preheat my oven. I'm like, trust me, it's not time yet. I said, you know what? I'll start my timer. We'll see. And I was right. Okay. I really don't know, like, how. I guess. Okay, this is a good system, maybe. Maybe I'll do, like, a couple layers to make it go faster. Ooh, look at that. I mean, it's not perfect, but it'll do. I don't know what I'm doing. Guys, ooh, like that. That's what I need to do. Okay. I got it. I got it figured out now. Okay. We're good. We're golden. I think. Well, we're almost there. This is a funky piece. Work into something that I probably won't even like. Oh man. Okay. Almost there. Quicken the pace. But not too quick. I want to keep my fingers. How did it cut? So far, I will say this knife is way sharper than the ones that I have. Now the pearly sauce will be good even if you don't like the fish. Yeah, that's true. Thank you. Okay, so place squash in a medium bowl. Looks like cantaloupe. It's not though. It's medium bowl. You're gonna have to chat about your knife skills later. Yes, chef baby. Oh my gosh. So I'm trying to make salmon with lemon caper sauce. That's my attempt. I'm not a chef. I'm not a cook. This is me trying and learning. Can one of my mods remove that person? Please. Conscious competence, stage right? Yeah, I slept a long time. Shut the door and don't come back. Yeah, I know, right? I don't understand people. Anyways, I have to drizzle with 1 tablespoon cooking oil. 1 tablespoon. Okay. All right, can somebody remove that person now? It does that. Around this time, all the psychos come out. That didn't have mommy and daddies to love them come out. especially. Okay, so yeah, I have a whacked up sleep schedule. That's it. That's all the explanation I have for anybody. there's no being nice for that. I appreciate that, but that one, there's a no patience limit on that one. Alright, foil lined baking sheet. Okay, foil again. Oh, NJ, thank you so much. Thank you for the rose. It's all good. Perfect. Chef Baby, what kind is it? Blasphemy. Shiny side up. Wait, is that actually a thing? Because there's two different sides, but it's not a big deal, is it? We're having, yes, we are. Maybe stomach user, yes. Cheeky nuggies, don't worry about side. Shiny side up. Yes, it does matter. Aw, thank you, Chef. Kay. Or Kayak. I had salmon for dinner. Oh, really? Also, I don't know if I'm gonna like it. We'll see. Chicken nuggies for me. So, can you tell me, don't worry. Okay, somebody says no dull side should touch the food, not the... Okay, dull side should touch the food, not the shiny side. Heat reflection. So you guys are arguing amongst yourselves. I don't know what to do now. And there's multiple chefs arguing. So less sticky. See, that I can get on board with. With a chef and his name over me. Well, there's multiple people with the chefs in their names saying different things. Oh, I'm so... Oh my gosh, good soup. This is war! All prepared in the way once for supper. Do what you want. Oh god, that's terrible. Day one chef here. We're going to war! But seriously. I mean, because I already have it how it is. Vote for microwave. Alright, you know what? It's just gonna be how it is. I guess. Is squash the same category as pumpkin? I guess so. Chef battle, go! We all get into the coma because we're all chefs. That's funny. I'll do half and half. I love that. Please stand by. Chef Josh. Oh my gosh, that is hilarious. No foil in my green. Yeah. Don't torch the food shining out. I cook on the fly. I see a rolling pin. I have not noticed any significant difference. Okay. Chef Jesper Mirror. Yeah, I'm hungry. Me too. All right. Gonna leave it how it is. We're gonna just do this sort of a thing. And do this sort of a thing. It does smell like pumpkin, but I mean, I guess it's squash, so I guess it smells like squash. It's just, I've never cooked squash before, so. But it's similar, very similar to pumpkin. I mean, it's a squash. They're all squashes, I suppose. It's just a different kind of squash, I guess. I don't know. I don't know what the difference is. I'm not a professional. I don't know what I'm doing. Chef Chacha! I'm a chef. It'll be okay. Not like the spores could get, right? All right. So now we got... Probably gonna have me do... Yep. Salt and pepper. Figures. All right, so now I got this. It's hard to do this. Here we go. Okay, that should be fine. That should be fine. Oops. Most of it got on the pan, anyways. Potato! Nope. It's for pumpkin pie. I do remember hearing that, yeah. I'm spelled different. Oh, thank you, Josh. All right. Now we are going to put them a single layer of lightly oiled roast 15 to 18 minutes. Keto's having a spaz time. Okay. Minutes. Put this bad boy on. Questions for the chefs. Does it matter the rack position in the oven for this? Because it doesn't tell me which position on the rack. So I have 18-year-old. This is what I live with. I would be better in a squash pot than you. So I've heard. Middle rack. Okay, it's in the middle rack. Center rack, put it in the center so it's even. Okay. I don't feel bad, of course not. Why would I feel bad? Okay. Did you say meow? Hey Siri. Set a timer for 15 minutes.
15 minutes, counting down.
In the fridge. Let's go. Oh, thank you, Nick. Oh yeah, we're at 2,300. Nice. Nicey nice. Okay, let me get my charger. And you know, I just realized I am super thirsty. And I... Is this the right one? Just refreshed my Dr. Pepper cream soda supply. Oh my goodness. Yes, thank you, Nick. Alright, there we go. Now we're charging. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, if you haven't, I'm addicted to this, and then they were out of this kind, and so like the substitute option was the Pepsi cream soda, because Pepsi cream soda apparently it's a thing now. And holy crap, I want that now. I just heard you call. Aw, thank you, Cole. That's such an is it? Oh my gosh, Dorvin, you're so funny. Right, it really is. This show is brought to you by Dr. Pepper. Right now, the fun part. Oh God, I have to touch the fish. Marinate salmon. My cat is going crazy. He's playful. I need to dry the salmon fillets dry, or pat the salmon fillets dry with paper towels. Place in a bowl used for squash. It's Keto. He's going crazy. We're still cooking. I know, right? Honestly, I need that reminder sometimes. Slight ADD brain due to medicine from autoimmune disease. It's like awesome. I have a terrible sleep schedule. I went to bed pretty late already last night, and then I was in a lot of pain, which is normal for me, but I didn't take any, because I don't like to take pain medicine if I don't have to. I don't like to, especially like Tylenol. I don't want to do it with regularity. It's not good. But I woke up at like 2 hours after I was able to get to sleep, and I was in so much pain I couldn't go to sleep. And so I took some Tylenol and I was able to get back to sleep. And I guess it worked so well because I slept for like 9, 10 hours after that until it was like 4:30 p.m. So yeah, just when you're ready. At the same time, no, it's not. It's never gonna be this at the same time. Remember my famous 3 hour potatoes, mashed potatoes? Yeah, that was a thing. Oh my gosh. I'm just like one of those people also that like I'm just a late person, like I'm late to everything, but also I just am more awake in the evening, like later in the day, not the morning. So please season with salt and pepper, drizzle. Okay, so I've never cooked with fish before. I have zero idea what I'm doing. I'll go half these. Fish real right. I do need a chef hat. Pineapple pizza. A lot of people have said that. I mean, I'll take it. I like her. She's awesome. I don't know yet. This one on this side, it doesn't. Oh God, I don't want to smell this. I don't smell anything yet. That's good. Just don't think about it. There's stuff on it. I still don't smell anything so far. I'm just like anticipating it, you know? Oh, there's fish skin. Guys, I can't do that. I can't do that. I mean, I eat meat, yes, but that does not mean I take pleasure or I don't find it disgusting. I just don't like to think about it. I swear. I swear. Yeah, there are real chefs in here. I depend on them greatly. It closer or I don't find it disgusting. I just like, so for me, like if I'm cooking like chicken or beef or whatever, like it doesn't look like any part of the animal, so like I'm mentally able to like distance that, you know? But this, there's an actual piece of the fish that I am used to seeing as a fish. This is not okay. The consultation team. It's natural, it doesn't mean that I don't wanna. It stays in the cooking for flavor. I don't know if I want the flavor. It's real fish. Peel off easily. Oh God, oh God, you guys. I don't know if I can do this. Oh, I'm starting to smell it. I don't know. Because you don't eat the fish skin, right? Please say you don't. Put it together. Oh, God. Just a text. Oh, my gosh. You don't have to eat the skin. The meat peels. Oh, God. Please just don't say that word. Don't. On the bright side, it doesn't have a strong, I'm starting to smell it a little bit, but it's so, so super slight. So that's a really good sign. Maybe not for you. I may be an actress, but I never act in my lives. This is genuine. I just laugh a lot more because I'm a nervous laugher. Okay, you'll be good. Skin side up. Well, at least keto gets dinner. Okay. Dry with a paper towel. Okay. Got it. Just don't look. Just don't think. It is just like chicken, but with a different colored side on the other side. It's a different color side on the other side. It's normal. I'm not. God, I'm touching it. I feel the scales. And I have to, oh man, I can't do that. I'm starting to smell it more. God, this, I don't know how or why did I think this was a good idea? Why did I think this was a good idea? See, and this is the funny thing. Like since I was born, actually before I was even born, I was going fishing with my dad, camping, because my mom would go. I remember when I was like 8 or 9, my dad like taught me how to like prepare a fish. I didn't like to do it, but it is my dad and I didn't want to like disappoint him. So I did it very reluctantly and traumatically. I never wanted to do it again. I don't like I understand animals, you know, circle of life thing. I have no problem with that whatsoever as long as it's, you know, humanely whatever. I just don't like to be a part of it. Like, personally, it's hard for me. I guess some people have told me I'm, like, super empathetic, so, like, that explains it, I guess, to them. I don't know. But I think about the animal as an animal alive, you know, when it's... So, yeah. Before I was born, meaning, like, when my mom was pregnant with me, like, they were probably going fishing and camping because he was always going camping and fishing. It just contains more omega-3 oils, so it's a bit more flavorful. Oh, and that's what I need. I need the omega-3 oils. Shit. I thought she was petting it. She's in the petting dry stage still. I am. Go, ninja, go. You can do it. I can do it. I don't like fish, no. I mean, I try. I want to because it is really, like, full of nutrition, like, good nutrition, or at least, like, some of it, at least. It's, like, nutrients that not any other food that I have normally has, but this is where I'm at. Also a definite possibility. I'm sorry, fishy. All right, now that we've patted the salmon dry, place in a bowl, use for squash, season with salt and pepper. know how much, I don't know what I'm doing at all. It's a good thing I did a lot of other kinds of food by this time, so at least, like, it's not me learning to cook all over again. Like, when I first did, Chef Baby was I think Chef Baby was my very first cooking live I did on, started doing. That was fun. So at least I have some more confidence, you know? I do feel bad. I just had a bowl of Frosted Flakes today so far. He was a good fish. He was. All right, cut machine. Oh my god. Oh, and it says. Two teaspoons of the leather of the lemon caper sauce with basil. Turn to coat. Marinate at least 5 minutes. Wait, does that just mean like I need a bigger bowl for that. What am I supposed to do? I'm supposed to marinate? I need like a plate bowl for that. So I don't have to touch the fish. Yeah, I have it set on my watch, so. Okay, so we're gonna, using this so I don't have to touch it. At least it does cover, like, you guys are right, it does cover that scent. And it already wasn't a strong scent, like I've, you know. Oh god, I had to flip it over. It's just a color. I need to mix this stuff. So I don't know what it's saying to. Okay, I guess I'll let it marinate for 5 minutes. I don't. Okay, I'm gonna wash my hands. Maybe, you know, this is what I need to do, you know, to get kind of like numb to it, you know? Maybe that's what it is. I just need to like to do it and then it's not that big of a deal, you know? Norman, I swear. Oh man. Oh my goodness. Hard part is done. Oh, there's the timer for the. Gotta stick a fork in it. It is. Okay, he was telling Sam to be like, thank you so much. What does that mean? Okay. That's funny. Okay, so I need to take this out. I need to process this. I don't know if I even need a cardboard. Oh, yeah, I do. Maybe. Okay. Is that how it's supposed to look? Where's my thing? I think it's supposed to be more brown. Like, a lot more brown. Oh, I'm supposed to roast some more. Okay, they're not done yet, but I don't know what I'm doing. Yeah, so it says in step six, it says we will finish in step six. We're only here. We're on two. For the remember, so I lose the team. Runs out of foil, game restart. I'm 30 minutes out. Please hurry. Alright, so while that's resting, we can cut the broccoli. That I can do. No issues there. Lengthwise into slices. About 1/4 inch thick. And also the artichoke. And then. Maybe a lot more brownish this shade. Sorry, everyone. Okay, so with broccoli, which knife do I use to slice the broccoli? Do I use the... I feel like I'm supposed to use... Oh, don't tell me yet. Am I supposed to use the utility knife or the chef knife? Or the shiitake knife? What knife do I use? Oh, my God. Chef knife. Okay. It's this one. That's not that one. It's this one. Aha. Don't use the dangerous one. Yeah, that's what it feels like. All right. So that's the corn broccoli. Yes, we are. Always learning. Grip the handle. Remember, grip the base of the blade with your thumb and pointer. Like this, right? The rest of the fingers grip the handle. So I'm going to use all the knives I am. Ting ting, yes, right? That's seen true chefs in the chat, right? That's what it is. Okay, so we go like lengthwise, it said. Let me look at the picture just to make sure. Okay, so yeah, lengthwise. Okay. Ah! Which timer was that for? That was a fish. I'm like, what was that timer for? Alright, so I guess I'm flipping the fish over now. To marinate on that side for 5 minutes. It does smell, like, all I smell is the basil... Pesto. No, closer to the blade. Cut with name of blade facing camera for print. like this? Then what's all this handle for? Oh, that is easier though. No? Okay, so like this, squish the base of the knife between your pointer, oh, like this, like that, okay, I don't really feel like I have as much control though. Okay, well, I like the other way better. Yeah, like this. It just This feels better. I feel like I can have more control, but that's just me. Flores, thank you for the rose. You're helping me to pay for my dinner I'm about to take out and order in, I mean. It was a healer now or two. Yeah, I don't like that. I guess I got. I figured it out. So I just have this finger up there a little bit. Did you see that? Cut in a pushing motion or on a straight up and down motion. Cut in a pushing motion on a straight up and down motion. Try to. Thank you, Chef Kick. Okay. Practice a new technique till it feels comfortable. Yes, not a straight up and down motion. Okay, so like this. I just stabbed one. Oh, that's so much easier. I got it, I think, ish. I'm getting there at least. Getting there. You're successful at trying, thank you. They grew up so fast. Just push forward to the blade. Yes, okay. For beginners, the tip of the knife should always be touching the board. Really? But then it scrapes across. I don't know. Slice in a rocking motion. JD, thank you so much. Thank you so much. It's funny, you guys are hilarious. All the stuff I've been in so far is mostly local stuff. I've done some commercials. I've been in several commercials through the years that you may have seen. As far as films, I haven't done anything like major yet. Hopefully one day. All the stuff I've done has been like, I've done some feature films. Like, if you go to my IMDb page, like, you'll see some stuff I've done, like, short films or feature films. But I am going to be in. I just finished one. There's several of them that I'm working on. I've done a lot of music videos. I have been in a lot of music videos. The ones that are my favorite are not out yet, but they will be soon. And I'm so freaking excited for those ones. I mean, I would love to. I just, you know, a lot of that just. Networking key is key, you know, and I haven't gotten the opportunity to kind of be seen in that setting yet, so yeah, so maybe someday. Okay. Got the broccoli. And I gotta chop this. So do I chop the artichoke hearts with the same knife then? Do you like an option to be sent to? Of course. Weren't you on video? Yeah, I wish. Although maybe not that one. I don't know. All accounted for. So do I use this knife for the artichoke hearts too? I'm trying to make salmon with lemon caper sauce. I would chop the artichokes. I would chop them. You can't really slide with these because they're all so squishy. It's all so squishy. Is there, like, there needs to be a chopping knife, you know what I mean? Like, it needs to say, like, there's the slicing knife. I need a chopping knife. because it's not my kid. Okay. Use double knives. Too late, I already chopped it. I am so hungry. Rocky motion might work. Okay. I wasn't sure if I was allowed to do that with this knife. Alright, what's next? place sun-dried tomatoes in a small bowl. I could probably use this bowl. No, not that bowl because I had the fish in it. Boy. I need to move you guys. You guys are blocking my bowl. Boss battle. Thank you. Thank you so much, Dorman. I'm better by the slice. That is good, actually. Okay. So I put these in a small bowl, cover with water, let soak for at least 5 minutes or until softened. That's weird. Oh, they smell disgusting. They smell rank. These smell rank. Yay! Yeah. Hold on, hold on. Because she turns everything into a bowl. I do! That's my life! Oh my gosh. Okay. Let me get this water. Okay. He's amazed or scared. I feel like that's both. He's like apprehensively excited. This is an antique. This is 1971. My gloves are, oh my god. Clean up, chef. Organize yourself. Wait a minute, what? You like the Mona Lisa of the kitchen. Why am I making food so late? Because I woke up at 4:30 p.m. and now I'm hungry. Lots of us in center. Okay, cool. Oh my god. Oh man. Cover with water. Let's soak at least 5 minutes. Oops. Turning occasionally? Oh, that's the fish. Where am I? Until softened. Once softened, roughly chopped tomatoes. Discard soaking liquid. Minced garlic. Okay, I can mince. I can use my new garlic mincer.
That's three.
Oh, shit. Okay. Where'd my garlic go? Where'd the garlic go? Uh-oh. Did somebody see where I put the garlic? Uh-oh. Oh, found it.
Sorry. You sort of feel like you're already taking a sneak peek of the menu.
Okay. It's like the saying, like, I love Jesus, but I cuss a little. Almost a fatal mistake, seriously. Well, I do have, like, frozen garlic cubes, you know, as an emergency. Thought this was pork chops, that's why I already ate my roast. I thought it was pork chops. Oh! Yeah, this is fish. Yay. Okay. Alexa, play the next song. Alexa, play the next song. Okay. We're gonna try out my brand new handy dandy garlic mincer. Hello. What is a Pika Pee? It's me. Stop. August, fish sticks in the freezer. are you going into fire? okay. You guys see this? I'm excited. Let's see if this actually works. It just squishes it. I mean, it kind of works. It's working. Not really. Okay, I'll shoot the other one. Maybe that'll... There we go. I just need to get some force behind it. That's what it is. Okay. There. Yeah, that's fine. It works. It's fine. Look, I got the minced garlic. I went back in the oven. It's probably cold by now. Well, I need to add the almonds to it and then put it back in the oven. So it'll be warm again. That's why I'm not putting it back in the oven, because it'll just be cold then. So it's still gonna go back in the oven. Is it easy to clean though? Yeah, because you just put it in the dishwasher. It's better than the other one I had. That was not easy to clean. She just hired herself back. I do. I fire myself and then I hire myself back. It does not smell. No. Nope. Not at all. Thankfully. After I put the paste dough on it. In the bank. Alien runs out. Oh my gosh, that's so funny. My dad always said that. I love that. Okay. I need to wait for the tomatoes, and then I can do that. I need to get a can. Whoa. Use this one. Why don't I use this one? I use this one. That's a close one. This one. I'm on the same page and focused with you. Oh my gosh, where are you? I'm in my kitchen. Without a doubt. In the kitchen, of course. I'm in England. Ooh, nice. Does the squash go back? Yes, it does. Not yet. I'm gonna put it in the oven once I get, without a doubt, in the kitchen, of course. I'm in England. Ooh, nice. Does the squash go back? Yes, it does. Not yet. I'm gonna put it in the oven once I get, I don't know when. I don't know when. When I get the fish on the oven, I guess. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. Are you going to call it? I'm gonna do it at 6, because at step 6, it says to finish the squash, so... That's what I'm gonna do it. They're going to call the cops. I am in the middle of the states. It is 2 a.m. where I'm at. So to go, chef. 8, feel free to eat whatever you're up. That's right, there's no cheating, it's not dinner yet. All right, so now I can get these done, I guess. Okay. So, and I'm supposed to get these? Steak, right? Thank you, best sous chef ever. Oh my goodness. Okay. So, roughly chopped tomatoes. Okay. Chop. So do I just like do this thing? Oh boy. Like that? Is that okay? Okay, cool.
stupid.
Thank you, Liv, so much for the roses. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right, so now we can move on. Cook salmon. Heat 1.5 tablespoons. Okay, so I need to clear this stuff out somehow. Somehow. Okay, I gotta move this over here, I guess. Gonna go here, and this is gonna just kind of way over there. Okay. Thank you, thank you. I need all the luck. I need all the luck. All right, so we're gonna do heat medium high. Is it always medium high heat, by the way? Like, is it ever like not? It's always medium high heat, it seems. A drizzle. Just a drizzle. Like my little olive oil bottle. It's my favorite. Okay. No, not yet. It is. Alaskan something. For searing meats. When in doubt, use medium high heat. Okay. Okay. So we're gonna do that and then wash our snow medium high heat. Remove salmon from marinade. So how it says to heat, so like how long do I have to wait? Like there's no like timer for when it reaches that temperature, you know? A king salmon. I have no idea. I don't think it specified that. It's just olive oil. Just like regular olive oil. If the oil smokes or shimmers. So I have to wait for the oil to do something? At least I win. 2 minutes? Okay. Give a minute on the heat. Okay. Okay. I can do that. I think. Where did I put? And that's all distributed. Yeah, it's an electric stove. Which time I'm invited over to eat? Yeah, okay. I get it. But it changes, like it's like the, like, see what I'm saying? Like it changes. The oil moves around the pan without resin. See what I'm saying? Like it changes. The oil moves around the pan without resin. Like not a lot. It doesn't seem like enough oil. I mean, maybe it's the size of the pan. Ooh, okay, that might be too much oil. Most definitely. I don't have any wood spatulas. I mean, plastic should be fine, right? It's just a plastic one. It should be okay, right? Safe. I'm trying to make salmon with lemon caper sauce. That's the hope. I don't think it even gets red. I don't think the top even changes colors, actually. Any slice does the special. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Same as my knives. All the, like, spatulas and stuff are just hand-me-down things. I'm going to eat the world bring dessert. Thank you so much, GT, for the presents. Thank you so much. Too many slots? What do you mean too many slots? Are they not allowed to have slots?
like left-handed spatula. Wild or farm raised? I don't know. Anticipate best. I did not eat yet. Mm-mm. Oh my gosh, GT, thank you so much for all the ice creams. I definitely want ice cream now. Plastic. Well, I don't hold it on it, you know. I don't have any wooden stuff. Blinker fluid. Fluid. Needs more blinker fluid. Okay, I think we're done. I think we're ready. It feels good. Feels good. Okay, so I just want to make sure I know what I'm doing. And wait. Bang, bang! Bane! It's kind of like I pick up only different cousins. Ah, thank you! How long has meal taken? Thank you! Yeah, I mean, I'm doing better. I mean, it's chronic illness, so, you know, it's always going to be ups and downs. But, you know, it's doing better than it was, overall. And I have to eat twice, wait on her meal to get time. What if I should eat? Oh my gosh, it's wonderful to see you again. Grade lower, so if it says medium high, medium even. With round holes are better. Longitudinal slots for more red meat. I don't know what this is. Just, that's way too advanced. Okay, so add salmon, skin sides up to hot pan, sear 4 to 5 minutes on each side or until fully cooked. So I'm just gonna call it a nice even 5 minutes on each side. And it says to do the skin side up first, is what I'm gathering. And then once I'm done, I just take it off, I guess. I don't know. All right, so this is the moment of truth. Since you wouldn't, yes, I'll add it to my wish list. Somebody sent me a brand new knife set, so I haven't cut myself today, this time. Copper pots are on the shopping list. I need to, yeah. I just need to add everything. I don't have, like, all the stuff I have is, like, hand-me-down stuff, usually, most of it. Why didn't it sizzle? Why didn't it sizzle? I was supposed to sizzle. Why is it not sizzling? Does fish not sizzle? Is it not supposed to sizzle? Old school pants. Yeah, I need ovens. It is hot. I mean, it's like I feel it. It's been on there for a while now. Yeah, and it's the dual burner. It's the right one. It's on medium-high heat. Like, it's on, like, number 7. I have professional stainless steel pans, and they do not stick. I use cast iron. See, the cast iron thing is difficult because then you have to wash each time. It's a pain in the ass. I don't like it. But it's been on the oven or the stove for, like, 5 minutes, I feel like, you know? Aw, thank you. Thank you, Bane. You're so amazing. Love you mostest. Alright, we're gonna try this again then, I guess. It didn't sizzle like at all. Where did I put the... What? Oh, there we go. It's kind of sizzling. There we go. Okay, there we go. I don't know. It wasn't sizzling that, like, one spot. Laser thermometer. I'll turn up the heat a bit. Turn up the heat. Okay, timer. Hey, Siri, set a timer for 5 minutes. And it's good, because all I can smell is that pesto, you know? And I love pesto. You're not supposed to wash cast iron. What you do... Yeah, well, when I say wash, I mean, like, you have to, like, rinse it out, you know, like, soap and water, or, like, hot water, whatever, like, rinse it out. It even you have to, like, add oil onto it or something like that. Jebidi, thank you. Pesto. Oh my gosh, thank you so much, Jebidi. No, you don't know, you don't know, you will rest you. Oh, wait, you don't? Well, like, not so. I didn't mean soap. Just, like, water to rinse it out. And then you dry it. You have to, like, really dry it out. That's how I saw, like, when I bought mine, like, it had, that's what it told me to do. Heat up, check the food. I'll turn it down a little bit again. People don't know, you don't wash.
Yeah, you don't soak cast iron. Clean it with salt. Yeah, baby, thank you. I grew up with cats and I know how to. My pesto! Turned down for what? Okay, so while this is happening, do I do something else? Oh yeah, because I still have other things. I still have things. Okay, so skin fed up here. Heat half tablespoon olive oil and saute pan over. Some marinade. Syrup, onion powder, and truffle cooked. And it says to saute veggies. Is it different? Is it okay? It's different. It's a different pan. It's a different pan. Okay. I don't have any room. I don't have any room. Broccoli, artichokes, tomatoes, and garlic to pan. Cook 4 or 5 minutes until broccoli is tender. Okay, so I'm gonna wait till I flip it because that'll be 5 minutes both. Whew! Now I have to know man's! It does? I love my olive jar. What time is it? It's 2:20 a.m. I woke up late, like really late. No gas. No gas. Now we have no fear. If you were cooking for me, I would still love you. I don't really have any. That's the kind of understanding I need in my life. Because I woke up at 4:30 p.m. I was in a lot of pain, like, the whole night, and I didn't get up to get Tylenol until then. And that's when I finally could sleep. I'm trying to cook salmon with lemon caper sauce. Is it thirsty already? whenever she's having. Well, it's not time yet. I have to trust the process. Okay, now I have this stuff I can add. Am I adding everything? Okay, so I'm adding the broccoli, artichokes, okay, so I'm adding everything to this pan. Ah! Oh, that's my timer. Shit. Ooh, that looks nice. Hey Siri, set a timer for 5 minutes.
5 minutes.
Right. Now I gotta hurry and add this stuff. Thank you. Now why this is doing, I could put it in the oven because that needs to go in the oven with the almonds for like 3 more minutes. So it should, maybe this will be the first time I have everything done at the same time. How crazy is that gonna be?
Okay, I got this. Sprinkle sliced almonds over baking sheet with squash. Carefully, baking sheet is hot. No, it's not. Roast 2 to 3 minutes or until almonds are toasted and squashes for two. Okay.
You guys, this is gonna be crazy if I get this all done at the same time. This is gonna be so crazy. This is gonna be amazing. Hold on.
Dude, you guys see this? It does sound lovely. This is going on to taste to me. I hope so. I hope it is. It's in your being. Am I living at this point? But it's my. Yeah, some cedar planks. That's amazing, but not any wood. Use something like pecan or cedar planks. See? Oh, done it though. Good serum. I just feel like baking is what I have to take. What is my fave? Give my bed. Oh my gosh. Okay, let me. I think this is cheese curd. Okay, so I feel good. It's always been there. It's Chef Smurf. Short order cook level 1. Not to burn anything, I'm starving. Oh my God, I'm so hungry. I got a pretty plate. There's this pesto, lemon caper pesto with basil sauce. It says, divide butternut squash with almonds and sauteed veggies between your plates. Serve salmon over top. Drizzle with remaining lemon caper sauce and enjoy. I'm hungry again. Hello, Alaska. Pesto. Watch the time. Yep, I got my watch alarming me.
That's a timer for this. It's still not brown though. Oh, that's this timer too. But it's still not brown though. The squash isn't brown at all. I'll keep it in the oven for a little bit longer. Okay, so fish is done. What's the white stuff on it, you guys? What the hell is the white stuff? That's disgusting. What is that? I do have a fire extinguisher. What's the white stuff? It's disgusting. It's not ranch. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. It's early. Wait, whatever. Whipped cream stuff. And I know it was a good call for this. Seriously, what's the white stuff? On the fish. Because I'm not going to eat it until I know what it is. Maybe I won't. Why is the white stuff coming on my fish? Just imagine your boy turned the oven on. Tiger. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Truly, truly proud. Melted marshmallow. Three men's skin flip for two. There's no pink. Wait, what? Oh, you're talking about Linden. It plunges it from steaming pot. Oh my gosh. Is dinner turd proteins from the fish? So it's okay to eat. Oh my gosh, Keith. Oh my gosh, okay. Okay, so let's see. I don't think this is gonna get any better, like more brown, I mean, so I'm just gonna. Maybe you guys were right. Maybe I was supposed to have the shiny side up after all. Why is it smoking? Shit. Ignore that! I didn't realize I got smooched over. Well, it's fine, everything's fine. Did you guys see that? Right after it's done, or is it supposed to be warm on the inside? Because it says 130. It says 130 in the center. Is that not enough? This one says 124. But it's been off the oven for a while. You know, is that... not cooked? It's good. Still cooking. Wait, what? I feel like I need to cook it for longer, you know? Like, if it's one, on this thing it says that it's, a fish is supposed to be 145. 145. It should flake apart. If you think it's icky, then cook it more if you don't. I didn't a little bit longer to cook. Okay, I'm gonna do that just because it just makes me nervous. I've never done fish before, you know? It makes me nervous. Yeah, it's not, like, it was like fighting to get to 130 on the one, and the other one was 125. So I'm just gonna cook it a little bit more, I guess. Spritz it. I should be fine. Okay, that's what I wasn't sure about. Cooking your captures real camera. The light coming out means it's overcooked. Wait, really? I'm so confused. So I put it, it can't be overcooked because I put it exactly for the time it said. Looks disgusting. I'm just gonna, oh yeah, I see it's like still pink over here actually. So that does look raw. I'm gonna cook it longer because it does look raw on that side, like pretty bad. Yeah, I mean, like, cause, like, can you see how pink that side is? I don't know if you could tell because the, yeah, you guys can't tell because the color is always off on TikTok. Freaking not helpful. Yeah, like, I could see the center and it's, like, still pretty pink looking. No, I mean, like, but, like, the other side looks cooked, like, a cooked pink. That side looks like a raw pink, you know? I don't know, it just makes sense to me. Not that I cooked fish, I don't know what I'm talking about, but... On the sides of it? Okay, that's a good idea. I think I'll do that. Because I didn't say to cook on the sides, but I definitely am for that plan. Because, like, that piece looks actually a lot more, like, uncooked pink than this one. So that makes me nervous. To the sides. Medium, medium rare. But this is fish. Like, do people eat fish? Like, is it, like, I know, like, beef, like, they do medium, medium, you know, rare, whatever. But do you do that with fish? Or is it, like, fish like chicken? You don't want to, you know, it's just one. Thank you, JJ. Work on sauce. Well, the sauce is done. I just need to add it. The chef. Should be firm. Okay, yeah, it's pretty, it's not firm. Like, on the side, it was really squishy. Oh, I can already see the color is getting, yeah, I see it. It's already changing color. Like, it looks cooked now, on that one at least. That was the issue. Okay, I feel better now. That looks better. Yeah, I don't, one step at a time. Well, like, I mean, there's sushi, yeah, but, like, I mean, I don't know. I don't eat sushi. I don't like sushi. Like, I don't know these things. There's a reason I don't eat these things. Smidge of butter. Oh, it's too late. It's already done. I'm gonna overcook it at this point, I feel like. On the bright side, the skin doesn't look like skin anymore. You can't eat salmon raw? Okay, it just sounds disgusting. Thank you, Faringo. I'll be right back. I'm hungry again. All right. So I'm gonna add half of this into my leftover plate for tomorrow. Way better. Oops, I actually squished the paste dough and it's all over my counter. Awesome. Oops.
Why can't I do anything right?
So this is my leftovers for tomorrow. Gotta get some of that stuff off the counter. See if I actually like this stuff or not. It's too spicy. Oh, that's good. Oh, I like that a lot. Now, let's go on the fish. Yeah. Whoops. Just poured it out. It's really messy. Okay. That up. It is a dinner for two, so it, like, I have dinner. I have, like, I only have to cook once, and then I have a meal for tonight and tomorrow. So I don't have to do all this over again. Oh my god. I hope I like it. You know, it's, I'm going to laugh and cry at the same time when I take a bite and I just can't eat it. Right? When are you guys coming over to do the dishes for me? I'm getting that good pizza. Oh my gosh, thank you. It's always right. It's bumpy Kool-Aid. Oh, come apart in flakes? Okay. Who's the judge? Wait, who is the judge? You two? What? You? What? So if she takes the first bite, it's going to be cold. Yeah, you're right. I should hurry. That's in the fridge, the leftovers. Just hope I like it enough to where I will eat the leftovers. But, like, again, like, there's, like, really no smell. There's been no smell, which is awesome. Okay, hold on. I'm going to get set up. You guys are coming with me. Does this stay on if I take it out? I guess so. Cool. Pinot Grigio. Okay. There we go. Frosty salt. I had it this morning. Okay. The oven is off. There was some doubt in my... You've done fantastic. Mistakes were never made as long as you learn. Thank you. Happy accidents. Should never taste fish? I hope not. Pasta goes on everything. It does. Seriously, I fully believe in that. Let's eat. No, I actually have done cleaning lives because it just is easy for me to actually do the cleaning. Thank you, Chef Kayak. Chardonnay in the stovetop too. All right, so I'm gonna eat the veggies. Shit. Hold on. Goodness. So now I have this is what I got. Okay, taste it. Well, salmon is generally more salty, so the more bold fruits that come through with Charnic. Ah. Look out, Food Network. Okay. I'll eat the freaking fish first. Oh god. Just hope the pesto is covering. Okay, so Because I really don't know. I don't eat fish. Is this a normal level of... Oh, I just cracked my back like crazy. Like, can you guys see that? Like, I'm trying to angle it. Hold on. I'm just going to flip the camera. Is this supposed to be that pink? Looks good to eat? Okay. Part of me was honestly hoping you'd say no, don't eat it. You probably, okay. I don't know which side is the skin. I think the skin's on top. Okay. I can't get it in a forkful. It's like, it's falling apart. I can't get it on the fork. I need chopsticks. Holy crap. The fork is just tearing it apart more. Say grace. Oh yeah, everybody say grace. Thank you for this food that I hopefully didn't mess up too bad. All right, so is this where the skin's at? No, I don't see any skin. Okay, you guys ready? I should lower this down more so you can see the food maybe. No, the chopsticks work way better for this. I can't do it. It was okay for a second, and that. I did. Shemaine. Hi. I'm going to try one more bite. I'm just going to soak it in pesto. A lot more paste. Just taking a smaller bite, maybe. Well, I can't give it to Keto with... Actually, I probably could. He has a special diet. I'm just drenching it in the pesto, and it's a much smaller piece. I just can't. Oh, but this greener than... Pesto? I've been saying... Pesto. Pesto. But I don't like that. I like pesto. 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 See, pesto just sounds like you're annoyed. I like pesto. 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 I don't say things how I want to say things. I'm gonna call it pesto. It sounds funner. It sounds nicer. Sounds more tasteful. Prego sauce. Okay, here, I need more. Pesto. That was fine. That's the trick. Pesto's a thing now. Yeah, pesto. So, that's actually how I used to speak. I'd get my A's and E's. Like, instead of, like, you know, begging, like, I beg of you. they wore like a grocery bag, I would always say bag. I'm begging you instead of begging you. I actually had to work on like saying my E's in those contexts, those kinds of words. I'd be like, and I'd always say like car, college. I don't know why. That's just how I always talked. But I worked on like saying it correctly, I guess. Tartar is the last resort. Honestly, the texture was getting to me a little bit, but then I started to taste it, and I wasn't a fan. It's fine in small amounts, covered, drenched in pesto. Cake or brownies? Brownie cakes. Cake brownie. Yeah, I mean, the pesto, I mean, who wants to say pesto? Like, seriously, okay, just hear me out. We're gonna have, like, a slight little, like, what you call it, like, a poll or a vote, if you will. Okay, I'm gonna give you two options. Just don't pay attention to what the word actually is supposed to sound like. Just pay attention to what it sounds like to your ears. Like, you know, like imagine you're listening to a new song, okay? Pesto. Say it again. Pesto. You ready for the next one? Pesto. 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 See? Pesto just sounds funner. Think of it more, not an A sound, but a E-I sound. Pesto. You know, like the P-E-I-S-T-O. Think of it like that. Exactly, an accented E. Exactly. Exactly. I do sound happy when I'm saying one, don't I? It just makes you happier, you know. Pesto, like, who? That doesn't bring joy to anybody. Pesto, or you say pesto. I'm converting it. That's how you just frustrating. You don't mind that, but pesto it is. Bella, Bella. A wonderful good morning. Pesto is my favorite. A pesto for your pesto. Oh man, I should eat my veggies. I'm just like having, I have all this fish and I'm literally just taking like tiny pieces and like trying to just cover it in pesto. Pesto. Gonna have the veggies now. I tasted the fish for a second there. Bye. I'm tired of your sleep. That was good. Vegetables are really good. It's amazing. Ew, that sounds disgusting. Well, it's okay. So this is the thing. It's not really fishy, but I'm very sensitive to fish smell and taste. So yeah. I mean, I feel like it's always gonna have some sort of like, you know, just really faint, and it's really faint, I'm sure, but I'm sensitive. I'm heater it. Wait, what happened? I'm heater isn't working. Your heater isn't working. Is that what you're saying, Shemaine? So I got it because it was a, I did like a free 7 or 10 meals with Green Chef delivery food prep things. And I'm trying to eat healthier. And fish is one of those things that like, it has a lot of the nutrients that I really actually need that I don't really get anywhere else except for like supplements. So it was me kind of like a last ditch effort to try to eat fish. No? I don't know what you're saying, Shemaine. Say, speak in a whole sentence. No typos. If your heater's out, do you need to come over here? Rest from next meal. I'd let you stop caring about eating healthier, love. What? No, I'm always wanting to eat healthier. I just don't always. I'm always trying. It's like working out, you know? I'm always wanting to work out. I just don't always do it. Usually ever. I'm really tired. Chopsticks. That was good. I don't know what you call it, like the dried tomatoes, sun-dried tomatoes, really good. I prefer no fish. I wish I could eat fish. I do. I so wish I could eat fish because it is so healthy. I mean, like, not every fish I know, but like in general, fish is like really healthy and an important like nutrient. I just can't. I tried lobster too. It's the same thing. My dad made lobster when I was over there for Christmas. I tried a piece and it wasn't bad. I honestly can't remember if it was bad or not, but I just remembered I didn't want a second piece. I don't know all the... You don't know all the fish! Oh, I mean, I already eat really slow with or without chopsticks. I eat with chopsticks because it's a lot easier to eat most foods. Like, fork, I feel like, is pointless. I feel all you need is a knife, chopsticks, and a spoon. That's all you need. A fork, honestly, is ridiculous. I don't like any sea. If it comes from the water, I probably don't like it. Tri-tip, yes. Oh my god. Yes. That stuff is good. But nobody really knows about it. It's weird. I don't know how or why. Like, I don't understand. Ooh, yes, main thing. That's where it's at. I will say the sides are delicious, though. To New Zealand prime beef. What's special about New Zealand prime beef? What's for dessert? I don't really have dessert. I have fruit snacks. It's down under. Those are kiwis. That was good. Oh, you're on the couch. That's funny. Oh my god. I don't even know how to explain that. Here, Jermaine, request to be, how do you do it? Request to be a guest on my stream, and you can tell the story to everybody. I'm very humble. Hi, Kiki. Here, let me see if Keto likes the fish. He's sniffing it.
I don't know if he's, yeah, he's kind of not, he's not for it. Kiki. Yeah, he's not going for it. Mm-mm. Maybe Keto and I are soulmates because he doesn't like seafood either. He's just staring at it. Shemaine, Shemaine. You got a request to be my guest. He's just staring at it like he hasn't moved. I don't have the option. I don't? What do you mean? It says it's on. Really? Thank you for hanging out with me. It shows it's on. Both of them are on. Maybe I'll turn it off. Oh, I didn't do anything. I didn't do anything. I literally just pressed it and I saw that it was on, like the green marker was on, and I just closed it off. So that's all I did. It must be a glitch. Okay, now Shemaine, request to be the guest. I didn't have it off. It was on, I swear. Besides the dish. yeah, besides the actual dish itself. I don't know. You're welcome. I have been. I'm out almost. He's literally just still staring at that fish. I guess Shemaine left. Shemaine! Shemaine! You sent it? There it is. It didn't alert.
Hello?
I can hear you. There, I can see you now.
Me and Dabby.
Oh, there's Dabby! Okay, so go ahead and...
Oh, he moved. He didn't want to be on camera. He didn't want to be on camera. I'm getting his butt now. Okay. There you go. Say hi, Dabby.
It is the best. Shiny side down to the sides.
So, you cooked the salmon?
I tried. Gross. I gave it my best effort. I give it my best effort.
Yeah, I've tried every single, well, not every single way, but every single way I've tried it, I have not liked it.
Yeah, I'm not a fan.
It's too wild tasting. I would have liked the vegetables, though.
Yeah, the vegetables are good.
Oh, great. My phone's about to die.
Well, tell the story real quick.
Okay. Well, hold on. Let me see if I can put it on the charger.
Okay.
Hold on. Okay.
Salmon. It's salmon.
Okay, there we go.
Salmon.
Okay. So, my favorite food is crab legs.
This is how much I love them.
And so, yes. And so, she went to Red Lobster with me, and I ordered crab legs. What? So, like, have you never seen anybody eating crab legs? So I order crab legs and she literally, oh, you got steak, right? Didn't you get steak?
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. We got our food and she literally put the menu up between us because she couldn't stand me. She couldn't stand watching me eat the crab legs.
Well, so we spent the part, it's the actual leg.
Yeah, so we went and spent the entire meal from the entree on with the freaking menu between us.
Look, up.
And then the waiter comes by and is like looking at us like, what the heck? And she's like, I just can't. I can't. I can't watch her eat that.
Well, because like, it's kind of like for people who were here earlier when I was prepping the fish or whatever, like, I was fine until I saw the skin side still on, and that I just can't, because it's like that's I'm seeing what the animal looks like before it's, you know,
And I can't, like, get my mind in a different box, you know? Like, it's harder to dissociate. So I'm just, like, see, every time she has a leg and she's cracking it, all my mind is doing is imagining a live animal having its leg broken. I can't. Like, it's fine.
Yeah, my mom.
It wasn't in the legs, like, the outer skeleton or whatever. Like, yeah. It wouldn't bother me if it's just the meat.
My mom's the same way. She can't do crab legs.
Yeah.
Dream Grand Buffet Weekly because I can eat.
She said they look like big spiders.
Oh. That doesn't bother me. It's just like I'm like feeling the pain, you know? And it's like,
oh my,
I don't have else to describe it.
Oh my god. That is like my favorite thing to eat. And this person says, I lived in Vegas. Yeah, like when I go to Vegas, they have the best because you can just go to the buffet and get all you can eat crab legs. And me and Matt will go there and literally not get anything else and just get crab legs for the entire buffet.
Dora, I mean, I'm feeling it for the both of us, though. the crab what? And me. Doorman said, but they don't feel it, though. I'm like, but that's just how I work. It's how I work. I kind of feel bad now. Yeah, so.
Yeah, they're my favorite, too. Especially with the, like, melted butter. Oh, my God. I love any seafood, really. Well, except for salmon.
Yeah, I mean, I can understand that, obviously. You know, again, I eat meat. It's just my brain has to, like, be able to mentally, like, what's the word I'm looking for? Like, differentiate, or not differentiate, like, what's the word I'm looking for? Like,
but you I know need I mean? Snacks. Like, yeah.
Like, if I don't see it happening, we don't talk about it, it's fine. I understand, and I'm totally fine with it being a thing that needs to happen, as long as it's done, you know, for the right reasons, of course, and humanely, but, like, I just don't want to think about it. Was that salmon farmed to table?
Oh, you know, okay, so,
I think it was
you know how I work... You know how I work at the fine dining restaurant, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I feel the same about that you feel about crab legs. I feel about lamb and veal. I can't eat those things because I know that they're baby cows and baby lambs, and I can't do it.
Yeah. I just gotta not think about it.
And I have never tried the veal, but I have tried, I mean, I've never tried the lamb, but I have tried the veal, and I can't eat even, I guess it's kind of like you're saying, like, it's psychological, I can't even eat it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, it does not taste good to me. And it's supposed to be, like, people, it's a delicacy, because it's a very tender part of the meat, but I can't do it.
Yeah, and I didn't know that about, I mean, like, the babies, I didn't know that that was what it was.
No, I've never seen cattle being processed, and I don't want to because then I couldn't eat meat.
Well, yeah, see, I just don't want to see it. I don't want to see it.
I would be so grossed out. Like, we were watching some documentary. I forget what it was, but it was showing how they treat chickens,
it's not about
and
them
I was
remembering
just disgusted.
It's not about if they remember, if they feel it. It doesn't, it, like, I still have, you know, I don't know. And,
yeah. Yeah, I can't remember what the documentary was, but it was on Netflix, and it was about, I think, food.
Yeah, because, I mean, creatures have...
I don't remember, like, what it was, but...
emotions, they have feelings, and even, but, no matter how long they last, like, it's just, you know...
But the chicken thing was awful. It was so sad, because the...
I don't want to know.
They come out as little babies. Okay, I won't tell you.
I don't want to know.
Okay. Okay, I won't tell you, because, like, don't watch it, because it's pretty upsetting.
Yeah, I don't want to know.
And then I think, oh, that's why I don't really like chicken that much. No. I can eat it, but it's, like, not my favorite.
Yeah, I mean, chicken is, like, the only meat that is, like, consistently safe for me to eat for health, and also what I can usually always crave, like, be hungry for.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Oh, so your friend's saying tell her.
Yeah, I know. That's Ferengo. He's always instigating things. He doesn't care about me at all.
I mean, I like chicken, but I'm real picky about chicken. Like, it has to be fried chicken or, like, I don't know, something with it. Otherwise, it's too blah for me.
Yeah, and I mean, like, I'm not somebody who's like, you know, it's just part of the world and part of, you know, I'm not like nobody should eat animals. It's like, I don't agree with people who kill animals for sport and like just waste it, and like it's just, you know, for that I think that's evil. But if you're using it for food, like a food source, that's different. I just don't want to be the one to do it. So other people can do it. It's like, yeah, I'll just go to the store and buy this mystery, like, origin meat that tastes good. Chicken plants, like eggplants, yes. Yeah. Chicken. Eggplants. Chicken.
Yeah, well, dude, my favorite, my favorite meat.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. Yeah,
farm fresh. Farm
so, raised. what was the rest of the meal that you cooked?
It was broccoli, artichoke, garlic, sun-dried tomatoes, saute thing, and then a squash with roasted almonds, roasted.
Oh, that sounds good. I like the vegetable part.
But isn't there something wrong with insulating ourselves from the reality of meat production? I mean, it's just a personal preference. I do believe that.
Oh, I don't want. Regardless, there needs I don't to want be to watch.
I do believe that it needs to be humanely done, of course. But I personally don't want to see it.
No, I wouldn't want to see it either because I couldn't even watch what I was watching. It was so gross.
I mean, it's like some people like. Don't mind hunting. I don't like hunting. I like shooting guns, but I don't want to shoot guns at live creatures.
You know, my brother and my dad used to go hunting every year, and like as they've gotten older, both of them have changed their opinion about it. Like neither one of them would kill anything now.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I mean, like I have a friend that like went, like that started doing hunting, and he's like, I really didn't like think I would be able to, because he feels kind of the same way, but he kind of like had this philosophy of like he's not hunting for sport, he's hunting for food, and he doesn't waste, you know, anything on it, like literally. And he always like kind of like honors, you know, each kill. So I'm like, I can get on board with that, you know. And I don't like the only kind of hunters that I truly have a disgust for are those who truly just are doing it for sport, who have no, like, have complete disregard for a animal creature's life, you know. And they're just, you know, that I can't get on board with, not in any way.
Yeah, I mean, my dad, his family, they used to actually hunt to actually survive, you know. They'd go out and
and totally understandable.
Hunt squirrels and rabbit and deer. This was a long time ago, like, you know, my dad was born in 1935, so things were a lot different.
You should be waiting tables. It's funny.
I didn't know if he meant me or you.
I got a black shirt on too. Your shirt, so.
Oh, okay. I know, because I got this thing propped up on the pillow. Oh. There we go. Tornado may drink through you.
You've seen
looks
how
like
I cook.
A nail salon shirt.
I would not.
Looks like a nail salon shirt.
I've never done waiting. Shemaine's the waitress. Shemaine can take your drink.
What can I get for you? You want long or short nail? Because they said it looks like a nail salon shirt. You want long or short nail? You want long or short nail?
Like, why are you
Long or short nail? You have boyfriend? You have boyfriend?
Oh my gosh, that is okay. That is a thing. Yeah, that is actually a thing.
You have boyfriend? I do for you. I do for you. Only $5 more.
Oh my God,
Only
stop.
$5 more.
I'm gonna get reported for racist content.
It's a skit. You never seen it?
I'm sure it's a skit.
No,
I
it's a
just
stand-up
know.
act.
Yeah, I just know TikTok, somebody's gonna ban it for being racist.
Actually, they actually there I've seen it on here. You can do a voice, you can do whatever those sound bites. It's on here.
What is it?
The what I was saying, there's sound bites on here for that.
Oh, nice. Okay, cool. Yeah, I mean, that's fine. I just like to be careful. The salmon, it turned out really good. I just don't like it. Yeah, I'm just
Oh,
thinking
see,
of when I
he
was.
said I'm on point with that, see?
That's fine. That's not a personal attack. I just, try to be
I
careful in
know, I'm
my
just
life.
joking. I know,
Okay,
I know,
okay,
I know. I know
okay.
because I remember, like, didn't you somebody
Yeah,
for something stupid?
I didn't even
I
do
forget
anything
what
at
it
all.
was. Yeah.
I didn't even do anything. That's the thing. This is my rifle. This is my gun. This one's my. That's funny. Yeah, I just know on here it's honestly like the Wild West. It's ridiculous. Just a terrible decision. Exactly. Exactly.
What'd you say?
Oh, cooked the fish was cooked well. It was just a terrible decision.
Oh, got ya.
So I put a piece of the fish on the floor for Keto. He
Yeah.
has been staring at it ever since. He did move, and he's still just staring at it from a new position.
Do you do pedicures? Yeah, can I say it? Yeah, I do pedicure.
My cat Keto is Kito, not the diet. Yeah, I mean the salmon came out fine. I just don't like it. Oh, dude, I just saw that there's a wish list. Oh, Clint, there's oh, how cool is that?
What?
So on the live here, I got enough roses. I just need hand hearts. I need 50 hand hearts and 20 gold mine gifts and
What's that? I
show
mean, where's that?
appreciation for gifters. How do I show appreciation? Coins. It says show appreciation. So if Andrew, Pluris, NJ, Chef Baby, and JD and Liv all have gifted to me towards my wish list. I on the TikTok live. That's cool. I didn't realize that was there. Cooking with the Tuco chef. No, it's in a ponytail. Never seen a cat. Yeah, me and Keto.
What?
Hold on, hold on.
Is he eating it?
No, he's not, but hold on. I just went over. Keto broke again. Keto is
Keto.
malfunctioning.
Hi, baby Keto.
Keto,
Aw, you miss me? You miss me?
doing?
Hi. Hi, Keto. Aw,
Keto,
Keto,
what are
you
you
want to
doing?
talk to Dobby?
Are you
You want to
malfunctioning?
talk to Dobby, Keto?
You want to talk to Dobby?
I gotta figure out how to turn the camera on. Oh shoot, I don't know how to turn the camera on when I'm like this. Oh, here we go. I found it. Oops, I found it.
I scared him.
Aw, say hi, Keto. Say hi to Keto.
Come here.
Oh, actually, let me switch it this way.
Need to hit
welcome to Cat TikTok, where cats can have conversations.
Not responding right.
Oh,
yeah, my sock.
He's turning. Oh, he's come on. What are you doing? Come back. Come back. Oh, he's going in his thing. He's like, I'm hiding.
Meow, meow, meow. Here's some of the fish. Here. Keep, keep. Hey.
Welcome to Cat TikTok. Can you see him?
Yeah. He's like, what the hell is that? That sucks. Like, that's like the worst thing is to be allergic to pets. Dorman. Now I'm craving Starburst. And yeah, Keto is an amazing cuddler. He and I, like, we will literally cuddle like humans. He, like, it's so cute. Come here. You hope to find a wife that's 11. What? What?
What you doing?
You want a 11-year-old wife that's named Karen? What? That's like the... Hopefully that's just like the really worst typo ever.
I know. I was having issues typing myself earlier.
I'm sure it was a typo. I mean, I hope it was a typo. No, that's not what I want. I want a Karen loving one.
11-year-old Karen, huh?
I mean, that's how I knew it was a typo, because nobody wants a Karen. This is the typo I have to speak into this. Oh, no. It's okay. It's okay.
That, look at that.
I knew it was a typo. I knew it was a typo. No.
Kitty, kitty, kitty. Kitty. That was
funny. Oh, then you'll have to register whenever you... Oh my god. You raised the t- Keto has moved over and is also once again on his belly.
Hi, give me Keto. That belly.
Let me rewind your life and maybe my daughter Karen 11 years ago to make him. Oh. Keto, why do you do that? I come to rub your belly. Okay, well, you guys, it's almost 3:30 a.m. Snort. Where do you go? Where do you go? Where? Aw, he's so cute. Okay. Are you going to bed anytime soon, Keto? Or Shemaine?
You mean Shemaine or Dobby?
Everybody! When are we going to bed, everybody?
Well, I actually was in bed. That's usually when I get on TikTok a lot. So I started to go through, and then I saw you were live.
Hold on, I'll show you what's for dessert.
Oh.
So.
Cookies.
So, quick story time.
So my godmom is what, you know, she passed away June 2021, pretty suddenly for me. And
so, yeah, that was fast.
And the Christmas before she passed away, so Christmas of 2020, she, because she would always spend Christmas with, you know, all the holidays with him, and she had renovated, or not renovated, like redecorated her house to like be like this teal color, and because she was just so cute, she's very fashionable and stuff, so she kept asking me like what I, what was it? Oh, that's right, that's right. So we were, I was over at their house for like just a regular day or whatever, and she's like, okay, well, you know, help yourself to whatever you want in, you know, in the kitchen, like food wise. And I'm like, anything I want? And she's like, yeah, yeah. And I'm like, so she had this cookie jar, and I'm like, okay. And she just like, she just laughed and laughed. And so for Christmas 2020, she got me my own same thing.
Was so it filled with cookies? It
cracked me up, huh?
Was it filled with cookies?
No, it wasn't. It was brand new. But yeah. But yeah, so I, you know, it was a really nice memory to have. So I made some cookies the other night, though. I almost put it on my plate with a fish. That would have been terrible. That would have been absolutely terrible. Right? Yeah. So it was a nice, solid laugh that we had.
Oh, I'm hungry. Mm-hmm. I should have come over to your house.
Oh my god.
I didn't know you'd still be cooking at 3 in the morning, though.
Huh?
I said I'm hungry, I should have come over to your house, but I didn't know you'd still be cooking at 3 in the morning.
I didn't either.
What?
Tiger, yes! Oh my god, that would be so cool.
What?
Uh-oh. Our, yep. Christmas cookie Twitch show. Mm-hmm. I thought of that. Nom, 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 nom.
What kind of cookie is that?
Chocolate chip. It's a Pillsbury dough chocolate chip. You just put it on cookie sheet.
I'm hungry.
Cookie is stuck. So good.
I ate a few M&M's, but I'm not probably supposed to have them.
Yeah. The M&M's should be fine. Well, this sugar. No, if you're dealing with inflammation, that's not going to be good for you.
And it has nuts in it.
Oh, well, that's different. Yeah.
Yeah, it's worse.
You don't want to have any nuts with what you're dealing with at all.
Yes, I know. But I only ate like 3.
I mean, not gonna hurt anybody but you.
I don't know.
Oatmeal raisin. What kind of psycho are you? Have oatmeal raisin cookies? Bane says, I got a batch of oatmeal raisin. I'm assuming he means cookies. Like, I had a high opinion of Bane, and now it's like, I don't even see it.
Yeah, I don't like raisins cooked in anything. I'm weird.
Raisins? Okay.
I like raisins by themselves, though.
Oatmeal cookies are bad enough, but then you add raisins to them? Like, what kind of psycho are you guys? White chocolate macadamia nuts. Yes. You are
Stop, man. Do you know what I'm talking
Yeah.
about? Peanut butter cookies are good. I just can't
Yeah,
have
I
too
love
many.
peanut butter cookies. Well, chocolate chip and peanut butter are my favorite. Yeah, I don't like raisins cooked in anything. I don't know why. I can eat
I
a
mean, I like
raisins by
raisins.
themselves. Yeah, me
Yeah.
too. Like I can eat a box of raisins, but like cooked in something, I don't like it.
Tiger, you had me, like, you had my heart racing for a second because I seriously thought you were about to say, hear me out, peanut butter and raisin oatmeal cookies. But thankfully, you said peanut butter and chocolate chip together. I could be down with that. We were talking about cookies. Yes. Yes, we are.
What?
I don't know. Why have a energy? What do, I don't get it.
Hi, you have a great energy around you and crazy colors. Wow, the universe is crazy. Lucky you. I guess they're reading your aura. I don't know.
Oh, yellow, pink, and blue may all. Oh, it's a little poem.
Oh.
Picture this pineapple pepperoni cookie blue jet baby. ET phones on. Same.
Huh?
Okay for us
Biscuits.
regular.
Okay, for us regular folks, they're talking biscuits.
And jalapeno. I'm trying to keep this
Oh, they're
moving.
cookies. Okay. Biscuits or cookies? I guess England? Is that where they're biscuits? Okay. I'm gonna
So
stuff you with
far,
oatmeal cookies.
the meal preps from this company, it's hard to say because I've only done two so far. So far it's fine. The first meal I made was really good. And
Oh
I'm
my
really
gosh, I
happy
can
about
hear you
it.
so much better. What did you do?
Huh?
Huh? I can hear you so much better. What did you do?
Oh, you're saying that to me?
Yeah. I don't
I
know
didn't
what
do
you did, but
anything.
I can hear. Oh, really? Weird.
Uh-uh.
Like I just like a second ago, yeah, you got clearer or louder. I can hear you better now. I don't know what happened.
Don't know. Yeah, I didn't do anything different. Biscotti. I'm a savage with you're not dipping in milk. Well,
Ew, I don't like.
I dip Oreo cookies in milk. That's pretty much the only cookie I'll dip. That's yeah.
I don't like dunking anything in milk. What? I don't like milk.
Haley cat butter, she said pumpkin cookies. I forgot what I was saying now. I don't know. I should probably get to bed though. So I still need to take a shower and brush my teeth and
No, I don't dunk.
play some rounds of
Do you
Scrabble or not Scrabble, anagrams.
dunk?
I dunk mint Oreo cookies.
Oh.
But I don't do like the
Ew.
regular cookies. I never did really. I mean, I had, oh, and like the what are they called? Like the ones that look like peanut butter, like peanuts, Nutter Butters. Is that the right
Oh,
one?
yeah.
Like those ones I will.
Ew, I don't like dunking.
Let's play Jenga. All right, I still need to clean the floor off with all the squash that got the squash peels on the floor. I wonder how they milk an almond. An almond has nipples, Greg. Can you milk an almond? Oh my gosh. Yeah, the thin or the thin mint Oreos? Oh, I don't know if there's I don't know the thin mint ones. I just like the regular mint Oreos. I don't know. I drank my peanuts and Coca-Cola.
Oh my gosh, I haven't had a soda in a week.
Yeah, me neither.
I just saw you drinking one.
All right, I'm actually having to wake up early tomorrow. Why did I do this to myself? I need to get to bed. I have to wake up at like 10 a.m. Why? So I need to wake up in 6 hours. I'm not even ready for bed yet. I'm going to get like 5 hours of sleep.
What do you have to get up for?
I have 2 appointments tomorrow. The chiropractor, I can't remember what time the chiropractor appointment is, though. That's a little bit later. But... Mm-hmm.
Hiccups and burps.
Got the herps. Hiccup burps collide. Thank you.
Four in the morning came when morning.
All right, I'm gonna go to sleep, or try to go to sleep soon. I'm gonna try to get to sleep so I can wake up. Maybe. I need to do things. I don't want to do things. I want to sleep, but I don't want to sleep. I hate sleeping so much.
I know.
Stupid sleep.
No, I slept late today too. I think I woke up at 1. No. It was like a little after 1.
Yeah, I woke up at 4:30 p.m. Stupid. Thank you. You're the only person.
Yeah, it wasn't that bad.
Thank you for another great evening. Of course. Being very free and sleep. Thank you guys so much. Thank you so, so much for all the likes. We're at 9,000 likes just about. And for all the gifts.
Are you want me to give you some? Here, I'll give you some.
Oh my goodness.
Wait.
I'm going to be streaming. Well, as long as I'm able to wake up in time, because I'm going to get home after my appointments and then probably sleep. So as long as I have the energy, what was I saying?
Hey, I don't have any likes, people.
Do you get likes on when you're a guest? I don't think you can when you're a guest. What was I saying? Oh yeah, I'm gonna be streaming tomorrow on Twitch, as long as I'm able to, like, not be too tired. It's usually in the evening, so if you're wanting to follow me on Twitch if you're not already.
They said the guest doesn't get any.
If you were to be a host, like a co-host or whatever, you probably would. But then you wouldn't be able to see the same comments that are in mine. Sorry, Pika. That's funny. All right. Good night, guys. Thank you for an amazing, wonderful evening. And I appreciate you all so much. I'll catch you on the cord. All right. Good night. Night, Shemaine.
Good night. Love you.
Love you.
Love you.
Bye. Night.